Hey everyone, and tonight was another episode of Star Trek Discovery. This one was pretty good, just like pretty much all of them have been. Anyways, so thanks to a little help from the Red Angel, the Discovery crew finds themselves outside of Saru's home planet. And, you know, you've got to get a little bit of a backstory on Saru. He basically was just intelligent enough to kind of piggyback a distress signal off of the bowel, and that's how they Starfleet found him. And actually the original Giorgio was the person who found him. She let him come with her. He sought asylum, and of course he never returned. Then he went into Starfleet and became an officer and everything like that. But it's been over 18 years since he's been there. Of course, now he has all this knowledge of what's really going on with his species. He knows that there is life after their what they thought was the end of their life. And so he's kind of, you know, he's wanted to come back, but he's fought with that. But now he is there, and he's pretty much under orders not to interfere, but he can't help it. They do end up going down to the planet because they're wanting to find out more about the Red Angel, what led them to this, you know, what the meaning is behind it. He goes down with Burnham, and we meet his sister Sarana, who apparently became a priestess after Saru was taken. Of course, they're not really for certain what happened to him. She thought that maybe he was taken because he questioned the Ba'ul. They don't really know what happened. So you get a little bit of a backstory there, some angst between them. Then the episode kind of heats up, and we find out that the Ba'ul know that Saru is there. They are fixing to target the Discovery until he is returned. And Saru beams himself back down to the planet where he is captured by the Ba'ul. Now, in the previous episode where we had the sphere that had all the information, they're trying to go through that and process the data. And they find out that the sphere did find out a lot about Saru's home world and the Ba'ul versus Saru's race. And you end up finding a pretty interesting twist was that we always thought that the Ba'ul were the oppressors, that they were the ones who were enslaving the Kelfians, but it turns out that at one point in time the Kelfians were actually the dominant species, and they were trying to get rid of the Ba'ul. Somehow they overturned them and the Ba'ul became the dominant species, and they basically have oppressed the Kelfians ever since. I'm not sure when this actually happened. The sphere took thousands and thousands of years worth of information from the planet. But the Ba'ul, we finally see one of them, and they're intensely creepy. But Saru fights back, and then they figure out a way to basically make all the Kelfians go through their process where their end of life process, what like Saru did, but you know it doesn't actually kill them. So they set up this device where it does this, and it basically makes all of them self-aware. The Ba'ul try to fight back, but the Red Angel interferes somehow, and we get another good look at the Red Angel. Saru definitely sees what it looks like, and it basically saves them. It powers down all of the Ba'ul's devices, that way they can't attack, and basically, you know, have the planet-wide genocide. So, towards the end of it, you find that Saru, he's kind of encouraging his sister to come with him, but she wants to stay behind. She wants to help their planet. She wants to enlighten everybody on what's going on. So there's that storyline. Of course, you know, she ends up leaving, or she ends up staying on the planet. Of course, he's gonna stay on board Discovery. So you've got that going on. So basically, he's kind of saved his species. You had another short little scene with Stamets' husband, and he's kind of realizing that he didn't come back correctly. He didn't have a scar. He feels different. So you had a little tiny little scene with that. That was about it. Then you had, towards the end of it, you had Burnham realizing that she wants to go home. all this stuff, seeing Saru and Serana, has made her reevaluate a lot of stuff with Spock, and she decides to go home to Vulcan, and that's pretty much where you leave the episode. So all in all, a good episode, another great special effects, great storyline. It was a really good episode, just another one. But like I said, every one of these episodes has been really good this season, so just another one. Next week looks pretty interesting, where they're returning home to Vulcan, and I think we're actually going to get to see Spock in this next one, so I'm looking forward to that one. Anyways, guys, thanks for being here. Thanks for listening. Leave me a comment down below. Tell me what you thought of the episode, and I will see you guys in the next one. Have a good one.